gonna try and see if this works. So, well, yeah, we're talking about keeping the main thing the main thing. Now, you have to ask yourself with your career, right? What's the main thing? The main thing should be something that you achieve over 5 years. It's a long-term thing. You're achieving over 5 years, 10 years. Maybe it is to become the expert business analysis, product management, computer security. In Africa, in the world, globally, but it must be the main, it must be something that you wake up every day and then you do something a little bit to work towards it. Right? So, for my main thing is to find the shortest possible path to grow a multinational technology company and find the shortest possible path to my $1 million, which means if I wake up every day, everything I do is towards that goal. It means the people I hire are people that fit into that vision. Even the events I choose to speak at and the clients I choose to work with, they're all towards that goal. And we'll achieve that goal one day, we'll move on to another main thing. But you've got to figure out, because you'll have experiences as you go into the workplace, and that might change what your main thing is, but it should be big enough that it takes you 5-6 years to make happen. Now, when you wake up every day, you must do one little thing to move you towards that main thing, right? So, I think when I got my very first job, at the time I said, no, I want to be the best technical architect that Ghana could produce. It meant that all these thick books that I read, that I would try all these at the time, I think Flink had been launched, I'm trying to use APIs, I read all these books, because my main thing at the time the best technical architect that would come out of that, right? So you've got to figure out what that means for you. And then work towards it. I believe in visualization, so write it down, draw it down, put it somewhere. Right? And somehow, I think when you visualize things, your brain helps you get there. Number 3 is stretch your mind. Stretch your mind, read and learn about things outside of your space. One of the things that I didn't do for years, because I was all about technical stuff. Now, a lot of the books that I read outside of entrepreneurship are around psychology, behavioral economics, and things that don't directly affect technology, but they help me understand and see and understand the world better. Right? So, there's a lot of collaboration to be had with the business admin students, right? So, they are better at putting to their cash flow statement. They are better at doing the numbers around if you want to be an entrepreneur. So, does it not make sense to partner with and learn from the business students? Right? Because, you see, the thing that going to make you slightly different is the fact that you have knowledge that you can come back and apply and take. Right? So stretch your mind, open your mind. Everyone that works for me, I think people say everyone that works for me is reading some sort of book at any point in time. I hope that they like doing this. Because we have a whole library and I just pick it out to people and I say, no, I think you should be reading this, I think you should be understanding this. I'm an entrepreneur that runs a tech business. So how does behavioral economics add anything to my life? But you know what? In understanding behavioral economics, I understand the topics that I work with. Okay? So stretch your mind, open your mind, learn about things that are not only tech related. I'll give you a quick example. example of many things that are not only faith related. So Lighthouse Chapel has, even though we're the Lighthouse Chapel Church, they have a branch in almost every nook and cranny in Accra. In Ghana and in the countries that we are in, there are, 40, 50 countries globally. I spent time actually looking at how Lighthouse prepares its pastors to get them to be able to be ready to go and start a church anywhere, anytime. You know how I applied it? Even in South Africa, it's in 30 African countries. How to learn to scale a brand, and then from watching how we change that. There are lessons to be learned everywhere. Okay. In a network world, trust is the most important currency. And I'm finding this more and more. You get paid for not only having a deep network, but having a trusted network. And then when I start what I'm saying about having a trusted network, okay. There's a lot of noise. People are used to new groups and new techniques.
Please go into one of the classrooms, please. I know it's horrible. Some of us will have to stand just for a while until the rain stops.